everybody. I am your Johan G.B., student of class 1, the Indian School, Bahrain. Today, I wish to give a speech on the facts related to Republic of India. Most of the colonial in India was under British rule from 1857 to 1947. Though India got its independence on 50 August 1947 from British, there were no proper principles or laws for the governing system of our country. However, 2 weeks later on 29 August 1947, a drafting committee was appointed for making a permanent Indian constitution with Dr. B.R. Ambedkar as chairman, who is known as the father of the Indian constitution. The constitution is the supreme law of India. Writing the constitution of India and completing it had taken nearly 3 years. The original constitution of India was handwritten by Prem Bihari Narayan Raizada in a flowing italic style with beautiful calligraphy. He devoted his 6 months to complete the writing. For that, he was allotted a room in Constitution House by the Government of India to execute the permanent work. Instead of charging any kind of remuneration, he had asked permission to write his name on every page of the Constitution and the name of his grandfather with his name on the last page. Each page was beautified and decorated by artists from Shantiniketan. The final draft of the Indian Constitution was prepared on 26 November 1949. And this day is celebrated as Constitution Day in India and also known as the National Law Day. The handwritten Constitution of English and Hindi was signed on 24 January 1950 by 284 members of the Constituent Assembly. The Constitution legally enforced and the national emblem was also adopted on same day, that is on January 26, 1950. Since then, we celebrate January 26th as Republic Day. This date was chosen as it was the anniversary of Purna Swaraj Day, which was held on January 26, 1930. At the time of its adoption, the Constitution contained 395 articles and 8 schedules and was about 1,45,000 words long, making it the longest national constitution of any sovereign country in the world. The constitution declares in sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, assuring its citizens justice, equality and liberty. Our constitution makers took inspiration from various other countries' constitution while drafting, which is why the Indian constitution is often called a bag of borrowings. The original copies of the Indian constitution are kept in special helium-filled cases in the library of the Parliament of India. Republic Day is not just an Indian festival, it is the festival of joy shared between people belonging to every religion, caste and creed. The entire country is decorated in tricolors to convey that India is a nation where unity in diversity is celebrated. The main Republic Day celebration is held in the national capital New Delhi at the Rajpath. The parade is presided over by the President of India, who is the Supreme Commander of the Indian Armed Forces. The parade shows us India's defense capability, culture and social heritage. It is organized by the Ministry of Defense, which are performed as a tribute to India. The first Republic Day parade held in 1950 before the first President Rajendra Prasad. On the evening of Republic Day, the President of India distributes Padma Awards to civilians of India every year. These are the second highest civilian awards in India after Bharat Ratna. The beating rate ceremony is held denoting the end of Republic Day festivals. It is conducted on the evening of 29 January, the third day after the Republic Day. It is performed by the bands of the three wings of the military, that is Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force. The venue is raised on a hill towards the end of Rajpath. Republic Day of India has great importance in history as it tells us all about each and every struggle of Indian freedom fighters. Thousands of people laid down their lives, so they're our country's breeze today. Never forget their sacrifice. Happy Republic Day. I love my India. Jai Hind.